Hi everyone, in this video, we'll learn how to import the cameras from Metashape into Wrap. So, you can align the camera with the model and edit it while comparing with the original image. Let's get started. In Metashape, I'll open the Workflow tab and click Add Folder. Here, we select the folder containing our files and load them as a single camera. We scanned an actor and got a set of photos. The photos were captured with 22 cameras. We'll use them to build our scan. First, let's align the photos. In the Workflow tab, I select Align Photos. In my case, I'll leave the settings at their defaults. The processing may take a while, so let me speed up this process. Great, now the camera positions are computed. Here's the point cloud. With this, we can build a scan from it. In the Workflow tab, let's choose Build Model. I'll set Quality to High and leave the other settings at default. I'll speed up this process as well. All right. We have the scan. Let's also generate a texture. In the Workflow tab, I'll select Build Texture, and I'll keep the settings at their defaults as well. We can set the scale explicitly by using markers. For this, I'll set the distances between these markers. I use Metashape markers, so I'll automatically detect them. In the Tools tab, I'll select Markers, Detect Markers. In my case, default settings are good. The markers are detected here, and here. Now we'll set the distances for these markers. Let's go to the reference panel. We'll need to switch to view source. I'll set the distance between markers 1 and 2. Select them, right-click, and choose Create Scale Bar. In my case, the distance is 0.04. Between markers 2 and 4, the distance is 0.02. When we set more distances, we make the scale more accurate. So I'll set up the distance for this marker as well. Here's what it looks like. I set the coordinates as well, so the scan stays at the center after processing. After that, we update the transform to apply the changes. The scan moved. Let's press 0 to center the viewport on it again. Now let's export our scan. In the File menu, I'll choose Export, Export Model. I'll save the model in this folder and name it Neutral Scan. In this window, I'll just click OK. Next, we can export the cameras as well. Export, Export Cameras, and name the file Cameras. Now let's open Wrap and check that everything was exported correctly. We can drag and drop the scan into the graph panel. The texture goes the same way. Here, I connected to the scan. We can press F to focus on the geometry. I'll also turn off wireframe, and I'll switch off lighting. After export, the model is near the center but looks small. It happens because Metashape works in meters. Wrap expects centimeters. We'll fix this later. Let's load our cameras as well. Cameras are loaded through the Load Camera node. From the list, let's take this camera as an example. This is how it looks. Since we work with small scale, we keep Override Near-Far Planes on to use custom values. Next, I'll choose the photo for this camera from the photo set. We can drag and drop it into Wrap. Then, I'll switch to the 2D viewport. On the image node, we see the picture from that camera. But like all photos, it has optical distortion. Wrap can't render the camera with distortion. For the photo, we add the Undistort image node. Image goes left, camera goes right. This is the photo with distortion. And here's how it looks after correction. Then, we need to use the Undistort Camera node. Now the model can be aligned with the photo. For that, we'll add the Render node. I'll connect the model, then the camera. Now we can switch between Render and the original image to see the result. Let's take a closer look. The alignment looks good, so we continue. The model is still small, and the rotation isn't optimal. This makes work with scans less convenient. I'll use the Transform node. Here, I'll set the scale to 100. This increases the size of the scan from meters to centimeters. The size matches, and we can rotate the model into a comfortable orientation. But I prepared the right values earlier, so I'll import them from this file. Now the model is rotated into a comfortable orientation. but the camera no longer matches. For the right position, we'll use the Load Camera Transform node. I'll load the same values from this file. There's the camera position before and after. With new nodes connected to the render, let's make sure the camera is in the right position. The model and the photo align correctly, so the transforms are fine. We already have the rat model, let's load it. I'll drag and drop the file. This allows us to compare directly with the scan. The geometry match looks good. Let's see how we can edit the model while comparing it with the photo. We'll do this with the brush node. First goes the rat model, then the camera, and the image. Now we'll switch to the visual editor. In the top panel, we can switch to camera views. Now we see the overlay between the model and the photo. I'll enable the use geodesic distance. Also in settings, let's change the geometry opacity. Hotkeys are listed here. I'll press X to turn off the wireframe and see the difference. The alignment is good, but the eyelids need a few fixes. With the move brush, we can adjust the geometry. You can hold the right mouse button and drag down to reduce the radius. I'll hold the middle mouse button and drag down to reduce the strength. I'll fix the lower eyelid. Now let's adjust the upper eyelid. Here we'll refine it a bit more. Now the model is aligned more closely to the front view, but we need another view to see if it fits well from a different angle. I'll select these nodes and group them with Ctrl-Shift-G. Then we'll copy and paste the group. In the Load Image node, I'll choose a photo where the eyelid is visible from another angle. In my case, number 14. Next, we'll set the camera to number 14 as well. Let's connect the new nodes. We can switch between camera views with shift space and check the other view. From this angle, we can improve the alignment. Let's do this. I'll refine the lower eyelid. Next, I'll refine the upper eyelid too. I'll switch back and check again. Looks good. I'll click accept to apply the changes. Now the model and the photo align more accurately. The eyelid is aligned with the photo. Using this method, we can fix other parts of the scan as well. That's all for this tutorial. We've learned how to import the cameras from Metashape, align the cameras with the geometry and wrap, and edit the mesh with the brush node while comparing it to the original photo. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.